हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म. माई सेल्फ इंजीनियर पीपी सर, योर फिजिक्स मेंटोर. तो इन टुडेज लेक्चर बच्चों, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एनर्जी, कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेज एंड पावर. सो लेट अस टॉक अबाउट कंजर्वेटिव एंड नॉन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेज. कंजर्वेटिव एंड नॉन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेज. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस टॉक अबाउट कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. So what is a conservative force? So you have to simply keep in mind that work done by these forces is independent of path traveled. It means work done by these forces does not depend on the path traveled. So for example, let us say that a particle is traveling from this point A to this point B, then it can travel by this straight line path, it may travel by this any arbitrary path, and this may travel by this path. So here are three different paths. So if we say that work done by path 1 is WA to B via first path, this is WA to B via second path, and this is WA to B via third path. So all these work done are equal. All these work done are equal. It means it is independent of path traveled. So by first path, by second path, and by third path, all work done are equal. So such forces are conservative forces. Now non-conservative forces. So non-conservative forces are path dependent. These forces are path dependent. It means work done by such forces will depend on the path traveled. So if we talk about examples, then we have previously also discussed conservative force, like your gravitational force, magnetic force, or electrostatic force. So these forces are conservative forces. Work done by such forces does not depend on the path traveled. And in case of non-conservative forces, work done depends on the path traveled. So such forces are like viscous force hota hai bachcho fluids mein. So viscous force in fluids and frictional force, or you can say any dissipative or resistive force. So work done by such forces depends on the path traveled. So if I again consider the same situation, that a particle is traveling from A to B via different paths, then work done by each path is different. Let us say this is path 1, this is path 2. So work done is W A to B, and work done from W A to B via path 1. So in both the situations, work done is different. So such type of force is known as non-conservative force, independent. Clear? So these are two types of forces. Now see, if we establish a relation in potential energy and conservative force, so conservative force and potential energy. So potential energy is associated with conservative forces by relation F is equal to minus du upon dr. It means negative rate of change in potential energy with respect to position is known as conservative force. So here, now see, if we calculate conservative force in individual directions, then we can say that Fx is equal to minus du upon dx, एफ वाई इज इक्वल टू माइनस डी यू अपॉन डी वाई एंड एफ जेड इज इक्वल टू माइनस डी यू अपॉन डी जेड, माइनस डी यू अपॉन डी जेड. सो दिस इज द वे बाई विच वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. नाउ सी, वैरायटी ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम हियर बेस्ड ऑन इक्विलिब्रियम पोजिशन और इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन. सो कंडीशन फॉर इक्विलिब्रियम इज दैट du upon dx should be equal to 0. So we have studied earlier also that if external forces, that is external conservative force should be 0, external conservative force should be 0. So agar bachcho hum yahan par equilibrium condition ki baat kare to us situation mein you have to keep in mind that external conservative forces should be 0. So here if f is 0, then you can say that du upon dx is equal to 0. It means change in potential energy with respect to position should be 0. There should not be any change, rather in we can say that there should not be any change in potential energy with respect to the position or distance. Then only that particle or that system will be in equilibrium. Now equilibrium condition may be defined in three patterns. So types of equilibrium, here we discuss types of equilibrium, like let us say first type is stable equilibrium. So condition for stable equilibrium is, see, primary condition is common in all three types of equilibrium, which is du upon dx or du upon dr should be equal to 0, whatever you say. So du upon dr should be equal to 0, this is the primary condition. And in case of stable equilibrium, we also calculate d square upon dx square. So if d square u upon, we are considering here r, so if d square u upon dr square is positive, then in that condition our system is in stable equilibrium. So two conditions are there. First condition is common, that du upon dr should be equal to 0. Second condition is that second order differentiation of potential. Now unstable equilibrium. So unstable equilibrium, in this condition first term is same, that du upon dr should be equal to 0, but in case of unstable equilibrium, d square u upon dr square should be equal to negative. It means second order differentiation in potential energy with respect to position vector should be negative, then only system will be in unstable equilibrium. And third one is neutral equilibrium. Third one is neutral equilibrium. So in neutral equilibrium, condition is very clear, that du upon dr and d square u upon dr square both should be equal to 0. So bachcho teen conditions ho gayi. Agar second order differentiation yahan par positive hai to stable equilibrium, agar negative hai to unstable equilibrium, aur 0 hai to neutral equilibrium. So these are three conditions of equilibrium with respect to conservative force and potential energy. Now one more thing which you have to remember, that let us say here f is equal to minus du upon dx. This is the relation. Here I am discussing two key points. First one, if x is increasing, x increase hota hai, and potential energy u also increases, then nature of force is attractive. Nature of force is attractive. So in theoretical type of question, you may ask that if x is increasing and u also increases, then nature of force should be attractive. It means there should be attraction type of force. Second condition which you have to remember, that if x is increasing again, if x is increasing, but now in this condition we are considering that potential energy decreases. Potential energy decreases. So during the decrement of potential energy, we say nature of force or nature of this conservative force becomes repulsive. It is repulsive in nature. Repulsive in nature. So if we draw a graph between f and x, u and x, then this graph found to be this way. This is, let us say, x, and this is your potential energy u. Then this graph is found to be this way. So this is the pattern of potential energy curve. So here these points represents, like this is, this point represents unstable equilibrium, this is stable equilibrium, this is zero equilibrium. So these points represents conditions of equilibrium. So let us discuss a pattern of question. Let us say that you are given potential energy as a function of x. It is a upon x to the power 12 minus b upon x to the power 6. We have to find condition for equilibrium. Condition for equilibrium. So first of all, equilibrium condition हमें बच्चों find out करनी है. तो हम क्या बोलेंगे यहाँ से? First condition क्या होती है यहाँ पर? du upon dx को zero place कर दो. It means differentiate potential energy with respect to x and place it equal to zero. So in this situation, let us say d upon dx value place करी तो a upon x to the power 12 minus b upon x to the power 6 and it is equal to zero. So a and b are constants. Here a and b are constants. So differentiation of x to the power 12, 1 upon x to the power 12. कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे बच्चों? इसको न्यूमरेटर में ले जाएंगे, वही हो गया x टू द पावर माइनस 12. और डिफरेंशिएशन में क्या होता है, जो भी पावर होती है वो बाहर आ गई और पावर में 1 से आपने डिक्रीज कर दिया. सो x टू द पावर माइनस 12 माइनस 1 मींस माइनस 13. अगेन सेम कॉन्सेप्ट इज हियर. सो हियर इट इज माइनस माइनस प्लस, सो इट इज 6b x टू द पावर माइनस 7 एंड इट इज इक्वल टू 0. सो फ्रॉम हियर इफ वी डिवाइड बोथ साइड्स बाय 6, then it is minus 2a upon x to the power 12 plus b upon x to the power 7 and it is equal to 0. So this is the first condition. Now calculate value of x from here. So value of x is, see, take x to the power 7 as common, or you can say that b upon x to the power 7 is equal to 2a upon x to the power 13. So it is b is equal to 2a upon x to the power 6, or you can say x to the power 6 is equal to 2a upon b. So value of x is 2a upon b and its whole power is 1/6. So this is the value of x where system is in equilibrium. So this is the primary condition. Now if you have to give exactly that what is the type of this equilibrium, then in this condition you have to calculate d square u upon dx square, and from there if you found d square u upon dx square as positive, then it is stable equilibrium. If you found d square u upon dx square negative, then it is unstable equilibrium. And if d square u upon dx square is found to be equal 0, then it will be neutral equilibrium. So second case, now second condition will be applied, which is d square u upon dx square. ये बच्चों अपन calculate करेंगे. So see, from here we found value of du upon dx. So value of du upon dx is, let us say this is the value. So I can say b upon x to the power 7 minus 2a upon x to the power 13. So I am going to differentiate it again. So d upon dx पी अपॉन एक्स टू द पावर 7 माइनस 2 ए अपॉन एक्स टू द पावर 13. नाउ कैलकुलेट दिस वैल्यू. सो अगेन इट इज इक्वल टू डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ 1 अपॉन एक्स टू द पावर एक्स इज माइनस 7 पी अपॉन एक्स टू द पावर 8. अगेन इट इज माइनस माइनस प्लस एंड 26 ए अपॉन एक्स टू द पावर 14. सो दिस इज द रिलेशन फॉर डी स्क्वायर यू अपॉन डी एक्स स्क्वायर. नाउ प्लेस वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. सो वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इज 2a अपॉन b. इट इज 2a अपॉन b एंड इट्स होल पावर इज 1/6. सो यू कैन गिव फ्रॉम हियर डी स्क्वायर यू अपॉन डी एक्स स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज जनरल पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चन इन योर कॉम्पिटेटिव सेक्शन. You will not get such type of complicated question. You will get simple pattern of question. But I took this example to make your concepts very clear. Now let us take another example, another simple example. Let us say that potential energy is U is equal to AX square minus BX. U is equal to AX square minus BX. So you have to give condition for stable, condition for equilibrium. And you have to also tell that what type of equilibrium is there. So in this condition, first case or first condition is du upon dx. So du upon dx should be equal to 0. So from here I am directly differentiating it. So it is 2ax minus b which is equal to 0. So value of x is b upon 2a. Value of x is b upon 2a. So this is the value of x from here. Now second condition is d square u upon dx square. तो बच्चों अगर आपसे ये पूछ ले कि बताओ भाई x की कौन सी वैल्यू पर ये इक्विलिब्रियम में होगा, सो कौन सी वैल्यू पर इक्विलिब्रियम में होगा, x पर. सो x इज इक्वल टू b अपॉन 2a विल गिव पॉइंट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम. नाउ विच टाइप ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम इट इज, सो कैलकुलेट d square u upon dx square. सो दिस इज वैल्यू ऑफ du upon dx which is 2ax minus b. Again we will differentiate it, then it is 2a because b is constant, so its differentiation will be 0 and 2a is constant again. So dx ka kya ho gaya bachon, dx upon dx 1. So it is 2a. So d square u upon dx square is, d square u upon dx square is positive. D square u upon dx square is positive means greater than 0, hence type of equilibrium is stable equilibrium. It is stable equilibrium. So these are the pattern of question which are based on concept of equilibrium in case of conservative forces. So ye ho gaya bachcho yahan par pattern of question. Now let us discuss power. What is power? So it is represented by P and power is defined as rate of work done. It is defined as rate of work done. So rate of work done by any machinery, by any person, by any object gives power of that. It is defined as in mathematical form work done upon time. In mathematical form it is work done upon time. So if we talk about its direction, then it is a scalar quantity. Power do not have any direction, it is a scalar quantity. Its SI unit is what? Its SI unit is what, or you can say joule per second, or joule per second. So 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. So if you have to define 1 watt power, then you can say that if 1 joule work is done for 1 second, then power of that object or power of that system is said to be 1 watt. So this is the concept of 1 watt power. It means if an object, in object works, if an object do a work of 1 joule in 1 second, or in unit time, then its power is said to be, its power is said to be 1 watt. Its power is said to be 1 volt. So this is the simple concept of power. Now there are some other units also. So if we talk about other units, then like horsepower, it is represented in HP. So 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. So you can directly, we ask this relation, that what is the relation between horsepower and watt, then 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. Or like another units, kilowatt, megawatt, so you easily know about these units. So kilowatt, kilo means 10 to the power 3. So wherever you see this kilo, then kilo means 1000, means 10 to the power 3. So kilowatt, megawatt means 10 to the power 6 watt, gigawatt means 10 to the power 9 watt. Clear? So these are another units which are used in power. Now see, if we talk about SI unit of power, then what is what is dimension of this power? So dimension ki baat karein bachon, so dimension of power is, so let us find out from here, m1 l2 t minus 2 and divided by t1. So power ke liye dimension ban gayi m1 l2 t minus 3. So this is the dimension of power, m1 l2 t minus 3. So here we have discussed some basic things about power. Now next let us see another pattern, another pattern of formula. See, like we have seen that power is work done upon time. So this work done may be different for different systems or different forces. So I can say that it is force dot vector displacement divided by time. Work done can be said as force dot displacement upon time. So I can also represent it as force dot d vector upon t. So displacement upon time, so displacement upon time gives velocity of the particle. So from here we can say that now it becomes equal to f vector dot v vector. Clear? So this is the another relation. So I am explaining these relations because these are directly asked in your competitive section. P is equal to f vector dot v vector, and you can see from here, in previous slide I explained you that power is a scalar quantity. So from here you can also see that power is a scalar product of force and velocity. So force and velocity both are vector quantities, but their dot product or their scalar product is always going to be scalar. So that's why we consider power as a scalar quantity. Now see, in different manner we can say, if next formula, if any object is raised to a certain height h, then, so in this condition, power in raising the object is, so see, power in raising the object is, now concept is same, work done upon time, but in this condition work done will be mgh. So power becomes equal to mgh upon t. So p is mgh upon t. This is another relation. In many pattern of question you might see that work done is simply measure of energy, you can say. So it can also be replaced in some pattern of question by energy. So in that situation also it will be joule per second. So let us see an example. So I am considering that a person or simply I say that water from a borewell, water from a borewell of depth 20 meter is taken out by a pump. Clear? So from a borewell which is 20 meter in depth, water is pumped out with the help of a submersible pump, or you can say simply a pump. And if kg water is pulled out in 10 seconds, then power of pump. So in that situation you have to give power of that pump. So see, here again I am talking about like this way, that this is a borewell, height or you can say depth of this is 20 meter. A pump is fixed at top and it is pulling out the water from here from 20 meter depth. So this water is pumped out. So here power will be mgh upon t, simple relation mgh upon t. So that pump is pulling out that water from 20 meter depth. And what is the rate of water pulling? So it is pulling 200 kg water in 10 seconds. So power of that pump becomes 200 into g 10, height is 20 and time is 10. So power is 4000 watt, or you can say 4 kilowatt. So power of that pump is 4 kilowatt. So this is a simple pattern of question which may be asked in your competitive section. तो बच्चों ये जो क्वेश्चन था, इस क्वेश्चन में अपन बात कर रहे थे दैट एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज रेज्ड टू अ हाइट ऑफ 2 मीटर बाय ए पर्सन इन 1 मिनट एंड अनदर पर्सन बी इज रेजिंग द सेम ऑब्जेक्ट अप टू द सेम हाइट बट नाउ सेकंड ऑब्जेक्ट टेक्स टाइम ऑफ 30 सेकंड. सेकंड ऑब्जेक्ट इज टेकिंग टाइम ऑफ 30 सेकंड. सो सी वी आर गिवन दैट वर्क डन बाय देम इज इक्वल. सो व्हिच वन इज हैविंग हायर पावर, किसकी पावर बच्चों यहां पर ज्यादा होगी. सो सिंपल कॉन्सेप्ट देखो, क्या बोला दैट दिस इज पर्सन ए एंड हियर लेट अस से इट इज पर्सन बी. बोथ आर रेजिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट्स अप टू द सेम हाइट, सेम ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ सेम मास बट टाइम टेकन इज डिफरेंट. फर्स्ट वन इज टेकिंग 1 मिनट, सो इट इज 60 सेकंड एंड सेकंड वन इज 30 सेकंड. आवर कंडीशन इज दैट वर्क डन इज इक्वल. So I use simply relation, power is equal to work upon time. So if I cross multiply them, W is equal to P into T. Now W1 is equal to W2. So from here we can say that P1 T1 is equal to P2 T2, and time T1 and T2 is given to us. So relation is P2 is equal to 2P1. So it is clear from this relation that power of that person B is twice of power of person A. It means हाई पावर किसकी हुई बच्चों यहां पर, सेकंड पर्सन की. सो दिस इज वन पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चन. नाउ नेक्स्ट पैटर्न ऑफ क्वेश्चन. नाउ वी आर कंसीडरिंग दैट एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ 20 केजी मास वाज इनिशियली एट रेस्ट, देन अ पर्सन इज पुलिंग दिस ऑब्जेक्ट बाय अप्लाइंग अ फोर्स ऑफ 12 न्यूटन एंड by moving constant acceleration up to height of 48 meter, finally its velocity becomes v. So what we are given that find power of that person applied on that object in pulling the object. So first of all identify the formula. Formula ko identify karo bachcho yahan par. To formula dekho, given kya hai, force given hai, then displacement given hai and initial velocity given hai. So our formula is f dot d upon t. We have replaced work done here by force vector dot displacement vector upon time. And again displacement is given but time is not given. So displacement upon time can be replaced by f vector dot v vector, means it is replaced by velocity vector. Now see, दिस वेलोसिटी कैन बी फाउंड बाय यूजिंग लॉज ऑफ इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन. सो बिफोर दैट आवर फोर्स इज गिवन, इट इज मूविंग बाय कांस्टेंट एक्सीलरेशन. सो कैलकुलेट दिस एक्सीलरेशन. सो रिलेशन एफ इज इक्वल टू एम ए कैन बी यूज एंड ए इज 12/20 विच इज 0.6 मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्सीलरेशन बाय विच दैट पर्सन इज पुलिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट. नाउ वी आर गिवन इनिशियल वेलोसिटी, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, have to calculate final velocity and we have acceleration. So we will use third equation of motion, which is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. So initial velocity is 0 and we can directly calculate 2, acceleration is 0.6 and displacement is 48 meter. So v square becomes equal to 57.6 and value of v can be taken by square root of 57.6. And if we calculate this value, then it is almost equal to 7.6 meter per second. You can calculate exact value. I have taken here approx value. Now, force is 12 Newton and velocity is almost 7.6 meter per second. Now see, both force and velocity are in similar direction. So here I consider theta as 0 degree. So F V cos 0 degree is equal to F into V. So 12 into 7.6, which is almost equal to 91.2 watt. So this is the power of that person which is pulling the object of 20 kg mass. Now, one more pattern of question is there, which is based on stretching of spring. Let us say this is a spring. So in initial condition, there is no suspension of any object from it. Now we have suspended an object of mass 200 gram on it in its vertical position. Then it is found that it expands by 20 centimeter in 1 second of time. It is expanding by 20 centimeter in 1 second. So you have to calculate power consumed if spring constant is 2 into 10 to the power minus 2 Newton per meter. So see, again our main formula is power is equal to work upon time, but here work done in stretching is half kx square. Now our time is 1 second, so calculate value of half, value of k, 2 into 10 to the power minus 2, and x is 20 centimeter, so convert it into meters. So 20 into 10 to the power minus 2 whole square. So finally, power consumed is 4 into 10 to the power minus 4 watt. So this is another pattern of question. So in today's lecture, we have discussed variety of questions based on your concept of power. So another type of questions or similar pattern of question based on work, energy and power will be provided in our sheet so that you can practice in easy manner. If any doubt is found in solving any pattern of question, then you can ask us anytime. We will solve your problem. That's it for today's lecture. We will start new topic in our next lecture. Till then, thank you.